running back at Sundquist.
Whoa.
As he gets cleaned out by Wilson, Sundquist stays down. And a host of Blues are coming to talk to 43
Red. And Thorburner grab him right away.
Before I get going here, every GM in the league and most fans, being honest with themselves, would take Tom Wilson on their team faster than you can say Cam Neely.
Got Lelia joining him out wide. Jacob Lelia creamed by Tom Wilson.
Yeah, and if you ask any coach, any manager, they'd love to have him on his team. You know, it's just a matter of managing him a little bit. You know, make sure he doesn't cross the line, which he has a few times. But he puts players, defensemen, in fear every time he's on the ice. You don't think defensemen on every team, most of the teams, are looking over their shoulder when they know he's on the ice? That's the way it used to be.
It's unbelievable that it's not a suspension. What it did, it gave meat to everybody that's against the National Hockey League. This will be the poster boy. And it's a funny thing that Cooke never, watch it, here it is here. He never watches, he doesn't have a chance. He never ever hits the tough guys. It's guys like LeCavier or Cole or guys like that. And we're going to show you, now I want to show you the rule book. Can we come in to show you the rule book after that hit?
Match penalty shall be imposed on any player who deliberately attempts to injure or who deliberately injures an opponent in any manner.
I mean, I couldn't believe the furor over the thing. And Paris, it's a good job we got Paris as the safety guy, or what do you call it?
Yeah, he's director of player safety. I mean, he made the right decision.
Absolutely.
Tom Wilson and Matt Cooke are two of the most hated figures in hockey history. But there's a significant separation in the reality that one player has a fan club, while the other never did. Today, we look at the parallels and perpendiculars between NHL troublemakers Tom Wilson and Matt Cooke.
Wilson in on the wing, hands it off, got it, that scores! Tom Wilson with the opening goal of the playoffs!
Wilson is viewed as a top six power forward who's one of the most physical players in the league.
It's usually his...
Oh! Wilson, crush, kill, destroy on Zadorov!
And to coincide with that, he's apparently a great goal scorer.
To the backhand, he scores!
Over the course of his past three seasons, Wilson has spent considerable time with Nicklas Backstrom and Alex Ovechkin, scoring 56 goals through 183 games.
You ready to get some pizza? Let's go.
He's ruthless on the forecheck. He's big, he's got great hair, but he's also the league's most penalized player since his NHL debut in 2013. And yeah, it's not even close.
In. 10 seconds left. Marcus Naslund to the net. Stop. Scores! Scores! Matt Cooke cashing in. 5.7 seconds left. And they're still alive.
Flipping to the pest, Matt Cooke retired in 2015 after 1,046 NHL games through 16 seasons.
He'll win it easily. Cooke to the goal. Score! With his second goal of the game.
He was generally viewed as a third-line forward, but garnered reputation in being somewhat of a Swiss Army knife. Throughout his tenures in Vancouver, Pittsburgh, Minnesota, and yes, even Washington, Cooke spent time on virtually every line. In wake of injuries and suspensions, he played with Marcus Naslund, the Sedins, Sidney Crosby, and perhaps most notably, Evgeny Malkin. But like Wilson, though to a lesser extent, Cooke also took a lot of penalties, especially during his first three seasons with the Pens.
Hey
For the first 8 years of Cooke's career, he amassed 187 points in 505 games, while Wilson currently sits with 221 in 569 games. That grants Cookie a point-per-game average of .37, while Tommy stands tall with .39. But if you include the rest of Cooke's career, that's good enough to bump him all the way up to .38. In matching goal production through their first 8 seasons, Wilson sits with a goal-per-game average of .16 in comparison to Cooke's .15. But again, if you include the entirety of Cooke's career, that elevates him to .16.
And it's a keeping nip, and Cooke hit the side of the net. Crosby again, 2-on-1, empty net, and it's...
That's the highlight of the day, Brett.
Come on, boys!
What's even more interesting about their goal-scoring ability is their shooting percentages. Through his first 8 seasons, Cooke registered at a conversion rate of 10.8%, while his career shooting percentage was 11.9. Tom Wilson, meanwhile, 11% on the dot. Now, before I get too far ahead of myself, I do want to acknowledge Wilson's production over the past 3 seasons. In all of them, he's produced at a goal-per-game rate of .28 or better, a feat that Cooke never accomplished. But something that's worth mentioning is Wilson's shooting percentage in those seasons. In 2020-21, Wilson scored on 15.7% of his shots, and in 2018-19, he scored on a staggering 16.9% of his shots. But when you compare those numbers to his shooting percentages through his first 4 seasons, it does raise some questions. Through his first 4 years, he was a 7% shooter at best, but once he started playing with Backstrom and Ovechkin, those numbers started to inflate. It could be argued that those figures are a result of Wilson being used to his full potential, but to imagine a reality where he shoots at almost 17% on a regular basis does seem like a bit of a pipe dream. It almost suggests an element of luck, or that these numbers are at the very least a reflection of Wilson's prime in the NHL. It simply forces the question, is that pace really attainable for the remainder of his career? Matt Cooke finished his career with 6 suspensions, missing a total of 34 NHL games. Wilson, meanwhile, has so far been suspended 5 times, missing a total of 36 games. And to correspond with each player's suspensions are numerous offenses that somehow went without punishment. But for this portion of the video, I'm not going to provide any analysis or insights because these hits and plays speak for themselves. So sit back, relax, and enjoy or cringe at the clown college that is Tom Wilson and Matt Cooke's predatory histories.
Laquette was down on both goals that were scored by Eaton and Dupuis on the wall, and now one of the Rangers gets run over and loses his helmet. Isimov.
Here's the play. You'll see Sundqvist move across. And then down goes Sundqvist. Knew what happened to him.
He was dehydrated, I believe.
And he got plastered by Cooke here.
Blindside.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was high. That was distant, and it was high, and it was intentional.
Making that last move. Back to get it goes better too.
Hit hard.
Matt Cooke just crushed it.
Well, he hit him pretty much from behind.
Sunday afternoon in St. Louis. Capitals forward Tom Wilson was assessed a major penalty and game misconduct for boarding Blues forward Samuel Blais.
And let's see this from the opposite side.
That is nasty. That's a flying elbow. He's going to see, I guarantee it, he's going to sit some games for that one.
Thomas right there.
Yep. Right shoulder. Thomas goes down heavy. Yashkin's on the ice.
Okay, 4-on-4 hockey out of the penalty box. Watch Matt Cooke and Matt Johnson. Side of your screen, there's the hit. Now look at Matt Johnson. There's the two-handing slash. There's no excuse for that. That's a penalty, but then there's no excuse for this either. To me, they both should get majors.
There's the stick handle. You see Wilson come in. Zach Aston Reese. Now the principal point of contact there. Watch the head. Watch the head of Aston Reese. Let's see.
Tyson Berry taken
down by Cooke, and that's going to be a penalty.
To summarize, this was Nien.
Not gold. It's no fun. When you're first son gets up. God's freaking out the neighborhood.
Before moving forward, I wanted to take the time to discuss a recent Athletic article from Penguins beat writer Rob Rossi. The article, which was published just a few days after the Wilson-Panarin head slam incident, gathered the opinion of Matt Cooke himself on Wilson's actions. On the surface, it's the pot calling the kettle black. But within the piece, Cooke describes a process that resulted from his 2011 elbow on Ryan McDonagh. After the game, he met with Penguins then-GM Ray Shiro, who in summary said, "We're here for you, but this can't ever happen again." As previously mentioned, Cooke was suspended 17 games for the hit, including the entirety of the Penguins' first-round series against the Tampa Bay Lightning. A good deal of time to reflect, sure, but it wasn't until the following offseason that Cooke and Penguins coach Dan Bylsma put effort into changing his game. That summer, he and Bylsma went over 50 hours of video, where they analyzed other physical players such as Ryan Callahan, who was never suspended, in attempt to reflect and alter Cooke's ways. And after being suspended 4 times in 2 years with the Penguins, he didn't register a single suspension in his remaining seasons with them. He was, however, suspended in the spring of 2014 while playing for the Minnesota Wild when he ended Tyson Barrie's season with an irresponsible knee-on-knee collision, something he was known for throughout his entire career.
First and foremost, I want to say that I'm disappointed and sorry that Tyson Barrie can't play for the Colorado Avalanche tonight. Since March 20th, 2011, I've been a changed player. I've approached the game differently. I think differently about the game. At the end of the day, this situation was not my intent.
Applying this narrative to Wilson, though, you have to wonder where the Capitals' mentality is at in regard to his tenacity. Have they attempted to educate and reshape his physical style, or is it something that they embrace and appreciate about his play? It would seem that neither he nor the Capitals appear to feel any kind of remorse when it comes to his actions, given their generic blank statements paired with a tendency to play the victim card.
I don't think it was that big of a deal. I think it's being made a big deal of it because it was Tom.
Yeah, I mean, I saw the hit. I mean, his feet were on the ice. He stayed down with everything. Just looked like a hard hit in the corner. I'm not exactly sure what happened, but to me, it looked like just a hit.
You know, their guy goes to our net and kicks at our goalie and you know, goes in there with his stick. And, you know, at a young age in hockey, you're taught to stand up for your goalie. So that's what I was doing. And, you know, from there you have guys jumping on your back. And I think anybody's first reaction would try to be just to throw them off you and get wrestled them down to the ice.
Members of the Tom Wilson old-time hockey fan club will forever defend his actions with statements like, "It's part of the game," or "If you don't like it, go watch soccer." But if the ignorance persists, Wilson will be suspended again and again. He'll injure more players, and for the sake of recent events, let's remember what can happen when a player's head is slammed into the ice.
There's no way you can say that any bounty on his head, they got his head.
The Vancouver
Canucks vowed they were going to get more. They have gotten it.
Steve, I just want to apologize for what happened out there. That I had no intention on hurting you. That I feel awful for what transpired. To the fans of hockey and the fans of Vancouver. For the kids that watch this game, I'm truly sorry.
And the score settling has gone too far.
The point of this video was never to insult Tom Wilson's ability as a hockey player. It was more so to question it. Like Cooke, Wilson has time and time again proved his lack of respect for fellow NHL players with vicious and dangerous hits. There's simply no denying that. But behind that knowledge is a certain appreciation for Tom Wilson, one that labels him as this goal-scoring power forward, a modern-day Cam Neely, or a contemporary enforcer. Cooke, on the other hand, was never granted this admiration. He was vilified, like Wilson, and rightfully so, but he didn't have some cult following within or outside the fan base of any team he played on defending his cheap shots. He was simply viewed as a dirty player, a stain to the game, a pest. Despite that reputation, however, he was an effective hockey player. One that played 16 years, scored goals, made plays, and won a Stanley Cup. All things which Wilson has done and could prove to do better as the years go by. He's had some big seasons as of late. He's produced most admirably, given his tendency to make dangerous plays. I just can't help but wonder. If Wilson was 5 inches shorter and lacked a fighting ability, how would he be perceived? How would his career progress? The point of the video is this. Tom Wilson isn't Cam Neely, and nor is he Rick Tocchet or Brendan Shanahan. He's Matt Cooke.